Shalom, and welcome to Messiah of Israel Ministries' Hebraic Roots Teachings. I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and today we're going to be having a look at objections to the Jewish people to accept that Jesus, Yeshua, is the Messiah. And one of their main objections is that it is impossible for the Messiah to come down, walk in the flesh among the people, because that would be blasphemy. That would contradict the third commandment, which says, Thou shalt not have any other gods before me. And this is what they like to use as an objection that Jesus, Yeshua, could not be the Messiah. And of course, there are many, many Bible passages in the Tanakh and the Old Testament that show that Yeshua is deity, is God, is the Messiah. And one of the places that we like to go to is the book of Tehillim, Bet, Psalms 2, which speaks about God and His anointed. It shows the deity of Yeshua the Messiah. It shows that He's the Messiah to all nations. Let's have a look at the book of Psalms chapter 2, verse 12. Kiss the Son, lest He be angry and you perish in the way, for His wrath is quickly kindled. Blessed are all who take refuge in Him. And what we like to ask the Jewish people is this, is does God contradict Himself? And they say no. Do they believe that God is a liar? They say no. Do they believe that the Word of God changes? And they say no. Do they believe that God Himself will ask you to worship a different God? And they say no, that would be impossible. And then we take them to the book of Psalms, Tehillim Bet. We read the whole chapter of Tehillim Bet, Psalms 2. And finally we reach Psalms 2 verse 12, where it says, Kiss the Son. And kiss the Son in Hebrew is Nashku Bal Pen Yenaf. Kiss the Son is a form of worship. If God says in the third commandment, Thou shalt not have any other gods than me. And right here in the book of Psalms 2, verse 12, He says, Kiss the Son, which is a form of worship. Then He is saying that this Son must be God, because they've admitted under their own testimony that God does not contradict Himself. And usually what happens is the Holy Spirit starts to work and it opens their eyes to the truth that Yeshua, Jesus, is the Messiah. It's a very, very powerful messianic chapter, and it answers the objection that Yeshua, Jesus, could not be the Messiah because that would contradict the third commandment, Thou shalt not have any other gods before me. And this is very, very important because I know that the believers around the world are praying for Israel. And if you know what you're praying about, your prayer is much more effective. Many of you will have an opportunity to witness the Jewish people or have already been witnessing the Jewish people. This is a very, very powerful evangelistic tool in answering the objection that Yeshua could not be the Messiah because it would contradict the third commandment, Thou shalt not have any other gods before me. Psalms 2, verse 12, Kiss the Son, lest He be angry, and you perish in the way, for His wrath is quickly kindled. Blessed are all who take refuge in Him, the deity of Yeshua the Messiah. We end with the Aramaic blessing, the blessing of the high priest. The Bible says all of us have become high priests through Yeshua the Messiah. Numbers chapter 6, verses 24 to 26.
Yivarech Adonai vayishmarecha. Ya'er Adonai panav elecha veichunecha. Yisa Adonai panav elecha veyasem lecha. Shalom.
In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Amen. Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat sending you and your family blessings from Israel in the name of Yeshua, Amen.